I wasn't ready to go to college out of high school. I think after having kids and just starting kind of a career and then realizing that wasn't what I wanted to do, that really set me up to discover what it was I wanted to do and then go for it. The two gentlemen that really got me into research in the first place was Dr. George Clokey and Dr. Bruce Eshelman. Had those two not gone to bat for me, I don't think I would have pursued research, and I wouldn't have made that kind of my second family down at Whitewater. The lab has really been my home away from home, but that's what motivates me to keep going. Now I'm heading to the Brookfield Testing Center to take my GRE, the ever-important test to try to get into grad school. I'm assuming this is an important thing, and it's going to be a make or break on whether I make it into grad school or not. All my classes are in the morning, but I'm going to have quite a lot to do outside with getting my thesis done, and just the scope of the classes I'm taking are pretty intense. I'm ready for the challenge, but it'll be a tough one. Physics is very interesting. It's not my thing, but it's been very interesting, and I've learned a lot. And I didn't realize how much I'd actually use physics in other disciplines, so it's been a worthwhile thing to learn, even though it's been my challenge course. So we've started culturing fathead minnows in an environmental chamber, and we're going to use them to look at whole effluent toxicity testing and then kind of duplicate the field study to see if the effluent coming out of the wastewater treatment plant is causing male fish to produce a female egg protein, which male fish should not be producing.
The wastewater treatment plants aren't designed to remove those kinds of contaminants and drugs. And so many of them are actually being discharged to surface waters, streams and rivers in particular. And then the question becomes, are they coming out at concentrations that are going to elicit effects in aquatic organisms?
Every 2 days we had to go out and collect effluent. Effluent actually has a shelf life in toxicity tests, so we had to go out and collect it, and that required taking a bucket on a rope, and there's a kind of a holding tank that aerates the effluent before it gets discharged to the stream. And so every other day, go in and haul up 40 liters, kind of like they used to haul water in the old days, with a bucket and a rope, and we poured it into another carboy and then transported it to the lab. Every day we'd have to draw down the tanks, get the old effluent out, put the new effluent in. Yeah, it was moving a lot of effluent around during that experiment, so. So one of the first things we do when we come in is we make sure all the fish are alive, and then we note their numbers and look for certain characteristics on the males. We have to test the water quality in all the tanks to make sure there's nothing going on that could be hurting the fish. These are really nice. They're a really easy way to test for ammonia levels. So that's at about 1 part per million, which we don't ever want to go above 5. So 1 is not dangerous or anything. In order to test if vitellogenin was being synthesized in the male fish, we have to get a fish blood sample.
She actually caused us to take it another step further. We weren't working with fish, for example, and then that was one of her interests. So actually, her work has expanded what we've been able to do as a lab.
Yay, he's flipped. Okay.
We severed their caudal vein. We used capillary tubes to collect the blood, spun it out so that the plasma actually separated from whole blood. And then we used that plasma in an assay where if vitellogenin is present, it indicates a color, then the vitellogenin has been detected. So Dr. Harrahy is my mentor.
But it's my job to give her the tools that she needs to do what she wants to do.
I actually have her, Dr. Bruce Eshelman, and Dr. Paul House as kind of my my group of faculty that I go to for assistance in the research. And I'm really kind of looking for feedback on if you think I'm online, areas I can improve, any further suggestions that you think I need to incorporate within this. So Dr. Bruce Eshelman, he's had to put up with me since day one here.
Okay.
He's the kind of guy, he loves the statistics, and he loves to teach statistics. I am not a statistics person, so having him on my mentor team has been so important.
Unequivocally, this is the best honors thesis proposal I have ever read, and you and Dr. Harris should be applauded on the way this has been pulled together.
I have a great mentor who has to look at a lot of garbage that I shoot out there, so.
I know that, but nonetheless, it had to get pulled together.
And we'll just be in touch and go from there. Pretty much my typical day is I get up with the kids, get them off to school, and then from there just drive down here. I try to make my time here an 8 to 4:30, 8 to 5 kind of thing so that I can go home. This has really been my job that I don't get paid for, but will be in the long run.
So one of the advantages she has, though, is she's fine-honed those time management skills in comparison to a lot of the other undergraduates who don't have kids, don't have a spouse or a house to take care of, and still seem to have a hard time with time management.
Yeah, being married with three children, they're somewhat older, 13, 8, and 5. Okay, Ian, you're gonna peel a carrot.
Okay.
Having children and going to school and conducting research, it really helps you learn how to manage time. Yes, you can have an ice cream bar. In my experience, the faculty has always been accommodating if I do need to leave, or if something comes up that they recognize I'm an adult with other responsibilities too. I had an absolute blast at NCUR. I don't know if it was because we had such a university presence there, but I was able to talk to students from UW that I wouldn't normally talk to, music department, art department, that kind of thing, and it was just so much fun to see and talk to people about the work they're doing, and then kind of compare what we're doing here to other institutions. And I have to say, we were a cut above the rest, even in the poster presentations.
Would you like me to walk you through my poster? Sure. We've been working on a study that we could use to see if wastewater treatment plant effluent was affecting fish, caged fish, and mainly fathead minnows. And so we're looking to see if we can find the same kind of results here. Egg production, survival, the secondary sexual characteristics, and ultimately if male fish are producing vitellogenin when exposed to the effluent. We just ran this, we just got done with it, and so I don't have any concrete data.
Dr. Caffer came as a chaperone or a mentor on the trip, and he knew a lot of the faculty at UW-Lacrosse, so he set up an open house that the biology department put on, and it was good to see how other schools have their labs set up or what kind of programs that they have or what kind of their niches are that they like to focus on.
So for the students doing undergraduate research, I think are much more prepared if they want to go to graduate school or if they want to get a job, because employers or graduate mentors are going to be looking for those students who have those skills, and they're able to come in and not have to spend as much time training them, and they're already thinking in a way, a more creative way, I think, than your average student that doesn't do undergraduate research.
So there's something that's going into them, kind of altering their hormone levels, but we cannot say whether the effluent is doing it or if it's something else.
Oftentimes we consider this negative data. It's still valid data, but I think that can be hard for a student to deal with because there was not a big difference found. Lisa is a fantastic candidate for getting into graduate school, but she's a little more limited, geographically speaking, in terms of where she can go to graduate school. Because she has a family to take care of, there's also, you know, a need to, if you're going to go to school, there has to be funding, and if not, then, you know, you need to work, and that's just how it works. And Lisa's a little bit more tied to this region. This is where her family is.
my ultimate goal is to go to grad school, so I'm taking a little time off and I'll reconnect with my family and get some other stuff done or just kind of decompress for a while, but that's the path that I'm ultimately going to go down yet.
I hope I've influenced them, at least showing them that even if something they can't accomplish right now, it doesn't mean that they can't accomplish it later, because that's obviously what I'm doing.